Hello viewers, welcome to the another episode of ICSE Board Class 10 Biology, episode number 1.2. In the previous episode, we have already studied about the units, or you can say the outline of the subject and the paper style. We have also seen the marks that are allocated to the specific units. But in this session, we are going to study about the chapter from the unit 1, Introduction to Cell. We are studying about cells since last 10-15 years, or you can say from the grade 5, you are studying about the cell, its types, its structures, its shape, and what cell organelles are included or are there in the cell. So let us see. So here we are with the introduction to cell. Cell is a basic structural and functional unit of life. As you know, this is the pretty much very simple definition related to cell, and it is found in almost all books. And you also studied about its types, that is prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are very primitive, because pro means first, karyon, that is nucleus, and eukaryotes, that is very well developed cell. So there are prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are basically bacteria. They are singular, they are unicellular. But there are eukaryotes which are unicellular also. As for example, paramecium, amoeba, etc. You have also studied about the different shapes and the sizes of this type of cells. Even in prokaryotes and eukaryotes, you will see the different shapes. As for example, if I talk about a eukaryotic cell, neuron, then it is a star shape, WBC, amoeboid shape, RBC, biconcave, cylindrical shape. While prokaryotes like bacteria, they are of comma shape, rod shape, round shape, etc. We have also studied about the different sizes of the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. The longest and the largest cells found in giraffe neurons. Prokaryote, smallest one, PPLO. So prokaryotes and eukaryotes are two different types of cells depending upon their functions and abilities with the shapes and size. Prokaryotes and plant cell possess cell wall, while animal cell is without it. The main part is the internal environment, that is cytoplasm and nucleus. J.B. Purkinje was the first to say that the protoplasm is the living part of the cell. And this has proved years later. Cytoplasm consists of cell organelles such as mitochondria, lysosome, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, centrosome, ribosomes, and nucleus. As a part of it, there are also cell inclusions. Now, what are cell inclusions? Cell inclusions are actually a non-living stuff. It consists of starch granules, protein grains or starch grains or protein granules, as well as lipid droplets. Let us see the functions of the cell organelles. We are not going to study about cell in detail, but we are going to stick to our syllabus. So functions of the cell, mitochondria. Students write it is a powerhouse of a cell and they don't get marks because that is not the function. It is the name given to the mitochondria. So what is the function of mitochondria? It helps in the synthesis of ATP. Same thing for the lysosomes. What is the function of lysosomes? Students will write it is considered to be a suicidal bag. But no, it is not the function. The function is to provide energy by feeding on the cell organelles when the cell is under starvation. Ribosomes. It's acting as a factory for protein synthesis. Cell wall, protection of the inner environment. And it is freely permeable, allowing all the molecules and ions to move to and fro. Cell membrane, it is protection, providing protection, and acts as a semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable is selective in nature. It's allowing only certain molecules and ions to move in and out of the cell. Nucleus is one of the most important cell organelle of the cell because it acts as a controller and it helps in the transmission of genetic material from one generation to the next generation. The most important one is now, because this question is being asked in the board examination related to Golgi apparatus and endoplasmic reticulum. Golgi apparatus is also known as dictyosome in plant cell. In the animal cell, it is considered as a Golgi body. Its function is different in both the cells, but some functions are common. For example, it is the most important for packaging and secreting material. In animal cell, its function of Golgi apparatus or Golgi body is modifying proteins and lipids, removing processed materials from the cell, makes and secretes mucus, packaging and transportation, and formation of vesicles for the storage. But the most important functions is now. In mammals, that is in eukaryotic organism, that is in male, you know, the male produces sperm. So the sperm structure has head, neck and tail. The head has the most important part, that is known as acrosome. And this acrosome is formed with the help of Golgi body. And this acrosome contains the enzyme known as sperm lysine, which is important for the penetration of sperm in the ovum during fertilization. So this is one mark question. Please keep this one in mind. While in females, but in reptiles and birds, this Golgi body is helping in the formation of yolk. And the process of formation of yolk is known as vitellogenesis. The function of yolk is to provide nourishment. The humans, female, do not require yolk. Why? Because the nourishment is taking place through placenta. So the yolk is absent. The eggs without yolk is known as alacetal egg. I have just shown you the diagram where you can see the egg yolk, egg shell and the protein, that is albumin. The another function of Golgi apparatus and endoplasmic reticulum in the plant, they are working together for the function for the formation of cell plate in the cell division of the plant. So cell plate formation takes place during the cell division part. Now if you let me zoom it, you can see in the center of this part I'm talking about, in the center between the two cells, you can see there is a thin line. It is nothing but the cell plate, and the cell plate formation takes place with the help of what? With the help of Golgi apparatus and endoplasmic reticulum. This Golgi apparatus starts secreting polysaccharides, and they start collecting at in the center in the equatorial plane, and they unite together to form a division, unite together to form the two different cells. So the division starts from inside to outside, and such type of cell division is known as centrifugal cell division. The another cell organelle which is important, that is centrosome. Centrosomes are found only in the animal cell and generally have two cylindrical structures called centrioles arranged perpendicular to each other. What is the important function of this one? The important function of the centrosome is to form spindle fibers. It is present only in the animal cell. It is connected to the kinetochore of centromere of chromatids. So all these things are important. It is all one mark questions. It is amphiastral spindle fibers, and it is also helps in the formation of cilia and flagella. Here I have just given the difference between what is happening with the animal cell and the plant cell for the centrosome. So here once again, here spindle fibers are made up of what? Microtubules. The centrosome in animal cell is considered to be what? Amphiastral. While in plants, it is considered to be anastral spindle fibers. So this is all about the cell organelles and their functions. One more thing that you have to keep in mind, that in plant cell, what is happening with the plant cell, that some plants like tobacco, spindle fiber is forming with the help of polar caps. So that this thing you have to keep in mind. So let us go through the summary that what we have studied today. We have studied about the definition of a cell. We have studied a little bit about the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. We have seen the different cell organelles and the their functions, not in detail but just in brief. Functions of Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum and centrosomes are important. Terminologies like vitellogenesis, alacetal egg,
acrosome, function of acrosome, but then cell plate and spindle fibers. Hope you have enjoyed this episode. If you have any comments or any sort of doubts, please mention to me in the comment box. We'll see with the next episode. Thanks very much. This was the episode number 1.2.